It was a campaign promise renewed.
So it makes no sense to spend $3 million per prisoner to keep open a prison that the world condemns and terrorists use to recruit. Now it is time to finish the job.
The job is shutting down Guantanamo Bay Prison. Just last week, 5 prisoners were released, on top of 15 in December, 6 in November, and another 5 last May. The total number of detainees that remain, 122. But in light of the terrorist attacks in Paris, the one thwarted in Belgium, and the instability in Yemen, where many of those detainees are from, some critics want the president to back down.
After the rise of ISIS and ISIL throughout the Mideast, most people in the world are more worried about terrorists leaving Guantanamo Bay than they are the prison being open.
Senator Lindsey Graham, along with Senators John McCain and Kelly Ayotte, just introduced a bill to restrict detainee transfers. They say there are just too many unanswered questions.
Who is being released, and what conditions, once they're being released, are they being held or not held?
Dr. Matthew Levitt directs the counterterrorism program at the Washington Institute for Near East Policy.
It's not just a question of, okay, well then release them, it's finding a place to release them to. Maybe there's going to have to be new laws for how we deal with them, but I do believe that there's utility in closing Guantanamo, which is not something that we need anymore.
Any plan to move ahead will require many more details, especially since a 2012 report by the Director of National Intelligence showed that nearly 30% of those released from Gitmo return to terrorism or are suspected of having done so. In Washington, I'm Christine Frizzell reporting.